Hello, my dear students, research scholars and teachers in plant sciences. First of all, thank you very much you all for your kind support to this online platform for the students of life sciences, Botany for You, and also expecting such a support in future also. Wish you all very happy and prosperous new year 2021. Myself, Dr. Pitambar Humne, founder Botany for You and working as associate professor and head department of botany, Dharampet MP Dev Memorial Science College, Nagpur, Maharashtra, India, welcomes you all in this new lecture series on angiosperm taxonomy through this YouTube channel Botany for You. After complete watching of this first lecture in this lecture series, you will come to know about the contents and future upcoming lectures on this topic. If we see today's scenario, then we will find that very few students are attracted towards this subject. There may be various reasons behind this. Few of them may be lack of interest among the students, the language and terminology of the subject, way of teaching by the teachers, understanding of the topics, etc. But angiosperm taxonomy is one of the prime subjects, equally important, and also it is a basic or first step for every branch of plant sciences. And hence, it is very important to learn the angiosperm taxonomy by every stakeholder in plant sciences. I will try my best to provide every bit of knowledge in the field of angiosperm taxonomy through upcoming lectures. This may take you to many years to cover various aspects of the subject. Through this lecture series, you will get tricks and simplified lectures on UG and PG syllabi of most of the Indian universities teaching angiosperm taxonomy. On first attempt, I will try to complete UG and PG syllabus, and then for the every stakeholder in plant sciences interested in angiosperm taxonomy, like researchers and teachers also. I will try to make you aware and are familiar with thousands of dicot and monocot plants from angiosperms through this lecture series. If we go back and see the two kingdom system of classification, then we will find here the classification in which the angiosperms are most advanced plant of plant kingdom, which constitute about 80% of green plants on this planet. Here I am trying to provide you the type of classification or the position of angiosperm for the new students in BSc or new students for the life sciences. Here, according to the old system, that is two kingdom system classification, which is given by the Linnaeus, the all living organisms are classified into the plant kingdom and animal kingdom. Through this lecture series, we are dealing with the plant sciences or angiosperm taxonomy. Hence, we will see the plant kingdom. The plant kingdom again is classified into two sub-kingdoms. That is, one is Cryptogamia and the second one is a Phanerogamia. The Cryptogamia again subclassified into three divisions. The first one is Thallophyta, second one is Bryophyta, and third one is Pteridophyta. While the Phanerogamia, that is the flower bearing organisms, again classified into two divisions, that is Gymnosperms and angiosperms. The thallophyta again subclassified into the subdivisions into algae, fungi, lichen and Schizophyta, which includes the bacteria and other microorganisms. Here the angiosperms, which are considered as a most advanced plant on this planet Mother Earth, which are further classified into two subdivisions, that is dicotyledons and monocotyledons, on the basis of their characteristics. If we see the characteristics of the angiosperm among all other plants in a plant kingdom, then we will find that the seed is enclosed in fruit, unlike to that of gymnosperms, where the seed is naked. This indicates that whenever we are going to see the different fruits that we are studying that contain the seed inside the fruit, means such a plants in which the seed is enclosed by the fruit, they comes under the angiosperms. But if the seed is directly develops on the plant body, and if it is naked, then that will be the gymnosperm. And hence, on the basis of this, the angiosperms are completely different than that of the gymnosperms. The ovules are enclosed in the ovary, and because of that only there is a formation of the closed seed by the angiosperms. Because when we see the ovary, which is later on after the maturity, it will convert into the fruit. And this is the reason why the gymnosperm are not responsible for the formation of the fruit, because the ovary like structures are found to be completely absent in the gymnosperms. Then triploid endosperm present. This is a characteristic feature of the angiosperms, because in an angiosperm there is a double fertilization, and because of the double fertilization there is a formation of the triploid endosperm. Then presence of well developed flowers with specialized floral holes like the calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, etc. In some plants maybe these are different floral parts absent, or maybe their presence of the some additional floral parts also. Presence of double fertilization, that the both male gametes are used during the fertilization in same female gametophyte. One fuses with the egg forming the zygote, and another male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus to form the triploid primary endosperm nucleus. And hence this is known as double fertilization and triple fusion. The presence of vessels in the xylem and companion cells in the phloem, which is the characteristic feature of the angiosperms. If we see the gymnosperm and the pteridophyte, except few cases in the gymnosperm, here the vessels and companion cells are found to be absent. All type of habitats like the herbs, shrubs, trees, twiners, climbers, lianas, etc. are seen among the angiosperms. From microscopic to large or the huge plants is a characteristic feature of the angiosperm. They are classified into the two classes, as we have seen in an earlier slide, that is dicotyledons and monocotyledons. Pollination by the wind, water, by means of birds, insects and animals, etc., is also one of the characteristics of angiosperms. If we see the taxonomy, or if we see the different books which are available, every time we find that the taxonomy versus systematics or the systematics, and both the terms usually are used by many authors as a synonyms or alternating words. If you see the plant taxonomy, then you will find the similar type of the matter. If you see the plant systematics, then also it contains the same type of the literature. This indicates that the authors are treating the taxonomy or the systematics one and the same. But if you see the views of different authors, then we will find a little bit of difference, and rest of the characteristics are nearly the same. Here we have taken some of the views of authors like the Andrew Sugen. He has been given in 1986, and according to him, the taxonomy is the science of classification and relationship of angiosperms, and the systematic is a classification and relationship of organisms. If you see these both the definition, you will find that in both his definition, here only the science of classification and relationship is given in the taxonomy, and here it is given that the part of the classification and relationship of the organism. This indicates that the taxonomy and the systematics are completely overlapping with each other. Jones and Lushinger in 1987 proposed the study of classification means the taxonomy, while the study of diversity of the plants and their identification, naming, classification and evolution as a systematics. According to them, here we can find some difference among the taxonomy and systematics, as there is a broader scope of the systematics as compared to the taxonomy, according to Jones and Lushinger. But when we have to see the Greek meaning of these two words, then we find that the taxonomy is nothing but the arrangement of the organisms by rules, and the systematics means to put together these organisms. According to Albert Radford in his book in 1986, considered a systematic into a hierarchical level first, which includes the taxonomy and evolution. Means according to the Radford, taxonomy is one of the part of the systematics. And he kept the taxonomy in hierarchical level 2. That is, according to him, the taxonomy means the classification, identification, description and nomenclature. Usually in the UG and the PG level, we are also studying the similar type of the definition, that the branch of the biology or the botany which deals with the study of classification, identification and nomenclature, that is known as the taxonomy. But in addition to that, the Radford considered as the evolution, which is in addition to that of the taxonomy, which means the systematics. But if we see the others' definition or the definitions and the views of the other authors, then we find that even the part of the evolution is considered in the taxonomy. And evolution means what? The variation, speciation and the phylogeny of the organisms. And hence, this indicates that here the systematics is nothing but the taxonomy in addition to that of the study of the evolution, while the taxonomy deals with the classification, identification and nomenclature of the organisms. Then what are the objectives of this taxonomy? Whenever we are going to study any subject, first of all, it's our moral responsibility to know the objectives or aim and objectives of that particular subject. The taxonomy in present scenario aims to simplify the communicability and orderliness of living objects present in a vast array of life forms, which would have been like crying in the wilderness. It indicates that whenever we are talking about the taxonomy, the first main aim is to simplify the communicability of that organism with the rest of the world. the fundamental objectives of the taxonomy constitutes the following: identification of the species by comparing it with the already known ones and noting similarities and differences with others. Means whenever we want to identify the species, we have to compare it with the known species available, and on the basis of that we have to mention, we have to record the similarities and the differences with other organisms. Then second one, that is the naming of the species according to the established principles and rules for its easy communication with the bird. International Code of Botanical Nomenclature is there, which is responsible for the formation of the different rules, and we have to follow all these rules in the angiosperm taxonomy. And hence here, whenever we are providing the name or finding the name, there are the many rules. Then classification, or the grouping together of species whose similarities are greater than their differences, and awarding correct position to them into pertinent taxa. Whenever we are going to classify any organism, first our duty is to see the similarities as well as the differences of that organism with the other organisms. On the basis of that, where that show the more similarity, more closeness, more relationship, we will keep it there, while automatically on the basis of its differences with the other organism, it will separate out. Inventorying of the taxa or the plant taxa to prepare the floras, manuals and other taxonomic literature of the identification of the plants, and the preparation of such type of the literature in the form of flora manuals or the taxonomic other literatures, which will be helpful to the upcoming generations to study the angiosperm taxonomy. Then detection of the evolution at work, investigation of its causes and prediction of effects in the future course. So here, during the study of the taxonomy, we have to find out the evolution of the organisms on the basis of their similarity and the differences, so that it becomes easy for the future study, and to provide the basic services to other biological disciplines and draw data where from to establish the phylogenetic relationship among the concerned taxa. Even many peoples who are working in the plant sciences, they are completely dependent upon the plant taxonomist for the correct identification, and hence to provide the services to such a stakeholders of the plant sciences is one of the aim or objective of the taxonomy. If you see this complete lecture series on angiosperm taxonomy that contain the classification, then identification, nomenclature, description. The description includes the roots, stem, leaves, flower, fruit, floral formula and floral diagram. This is nothing but the morphology of angiosperms. If we see the complete angiosperm taxonomy, it is based on the terminology of the subject. When we see any plant, and if you go for the identification of that particular species with the help of flora or other available literature, then you will find the difficulty of the thing, and that is the terminology. Through this description, we will aware about the different terminology which is used for the description of the plant as well as identification of the plant. There are many words, many different terms which are usually not included in the routine books that we will see through this lecture series. Then modern trends in the taxonomy: numerical taxonomy, chemotaxonomy, cytotaxonomy, etc. Then origin and phylogeny of angiosperm, description of dicot families, and description of monocot families. So this will be the content of whole lecture series on angiosperm taxonomy. This will take few to many years to complete the complete subject through this lecture series. If you see the classification which are given by the different authors or the scientists who work on the angiosperm taxonomy, which includes the principles of classification, again artificial classification, mechanical classification, natural classification, and phylogenetic classification. Why it is important? Because if we see these angiosperms, they are classified into two subdivisions, that is dicotyledon and monocotyledon, which are further classified into 64 orders, 416 families, 13,000 known genera, and more than 3 lakh species with many subspecies, varieties, formas, etc. This indicates the scope of the subject and the future challenges to study the angiosperm taxonomy. If we see this artificial classification or mechanical classification or natural classification or the phylogenetic classification, then we will find that there are the certain characteristics which are considered during the classification, and on the basis of that they are categorized into the different type of the classification. In artificial system of the classification, the habit and importance to the man as a taxonomic character are considered in this classification. And the classification given by Theophrastus comes under this category, that is a artificial classification. If we see the mechanical classification, then if one or the few taxonomic characters are considered for the classification, then it becomes mechanical classification. And the classification proposed by the Linnaeus is the best example for the mechanical type of the classification. But if the many taxonomic characters are considered for the classification, then such type of the classification is said to be the natural classification. And the best example of the natural classification is the classification is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker's, which is one of the most accepted and usable system of the classification. It is easy to understand, except the position of the gymnosperm in between the dicot and the monocot. The rest of complete classification is very nicely organized. If you see the phylogenetic classification, it is just like to that of the natural classification, but here also many possible taxonomic characters are considered for the classification along with phylogenetic interpretations of the taxa. Means this is an additional thing which is to be considered during the phylogenetic classification in addition to that of the natural classification. And hence this type of the classification, which is based upon the phylogeny, means nothing but evolution, is referred as phylogenetic classification or evolutionary classification. Then the classification which are given by the different scientists or the different authors, which includes the classification given by John Ray. He was first to divide the herb, shrubs and trees into the dicotyledons and monocotyledons on the basis of number of cotyledons that comes under the classification proposed by John Ray. Corlinus, who is considered as a father of taxonomy and creator of binomial system of nomenclature, the Linnaeus divided plants into 24 classes mainly on the basis of number, union and length of the stamens. It is an artificial system of classification, but Redford treated it as a mechanical classification. Then the classification which is given by Antoni Laurent di Gesu, which is popularly known as di Gesu. He classified the plants into 100 orders, now as families, and 15 classes and 3 groups as acotyledons, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Then the next one is the classification which is given by A.P. de Candolle. A.P. de Candolle divided the plants into 2 groups on the basis of presence and absence of vascular bundles and 161 orders which are now treated as a families. The most favored and useful classification which is given by the George Bentham and Hooker. And in this classification, they classified the plants in 3 groups: dicotyledons, gymnosperms and monocotyledons, which contain 200 families, 7569 genera and 97,205 species. The most remarkable demerit of this system of classification which is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker, I already told, that is nothing but the place of the gymnosperm, which is in between the dicotyledons and the monocotyledon. But then also it is most accepted and natural system of the classification and followed in many places. The next classification which is given by the Adolf Engler and Prandtl system of the classification, which is also one of the most popular system of the classification, and it is well known as a phylogenetic system of the classification. In this system of the classification which is proposed by Engler and Prandtl, he divided the plants into 14 divisions. Noteworthy features of the system is that they placed monocotyledons before the dicotyledons, but now we are studying the dicotyledons before the monocotyledons on the basis of evolution of the angiosperms. The next classification is given by Charles Edwin Besse. He considered the angiosperms as monophyletic and Ranelles as the primitive angiosperms. He divided angiosperms into 32 orders and 300 families. Just like Engler and Prandtl, Charles Besse also placed monocotyledons before the dicotyledons. Then John Hutchinson, in his classification system, given the 24 principles, and he considered the angiosperms as phylum and divided it into 2 subphylums as dicotyledons and monocotyledons, which include 111 orders. Then the Armour Takhtajans divided angiosperms into dicotyledons and monocotyledons, which further dicotyledons divided into 7 subclasses and 20 superorders and 71 orders, and monocotyledons into 3 subclasses, 8 superorders and 21 orders. That is total 92 orders and 410 families. Then the classification given by the Cronquist, he classified the angiosperm into two classes as dicotyledons and monocotyledons, including 11 subclasses, 83 orders, and 383 families. He studied about 219,300 angiosperm species around the world. Then the classification given by the Robert Thorney. He divided the angiosperms into two subclasses, 28 superorders, 54 orders, 3 suborders, and 350 families, which includes 12,255 genera and 225,490 species. He also believes in monophyletic origin of angiosperms. And the last classification, which is given by Dahlgren, he divided the angiosperms into two subclasses, dicotyledons and monocotyledons, and he considered the monocotyledons as most advanced among angiosperms. Whenever we are going to see the different books nowadays, we will find that the monocotyledons are placed at the end of the classification in the angiosperms. Means a such type of the classification in which the dicot are considered as a primitive and the monocotyledons are considered as an advance, and this is to be followed in recent years. He divided dicotyledons into 25 superorders, 85 orders, while the monocotyledons into 8 superorders and 25 orders. Then identification. This identification includes direct comparison, then photo identification, and descriptive identification. If we see the direct identification, means we have to compare the species with the available identified species, or even we can identify the photographs on the basis of the visible characteristics. And the third one, which is most important, that is descriptive identification. If we see the direct comparison or the photo identification, you will find that the descriptive identification will be most authentic, because there are the chances of the mistakes in direct comparison or the photo identification. But when we have to see the description or all the taxonomic description of that particular plant, then it will show the similarities and the differences with respect to the different groups available in the angiosperms, which includes the flora, then manuals, chaclets, monographs, research papers, and keys, which are included usually in the floras. These keys are of again different types, that is punch card key and dichotomous key. And in most of the flora, here there is a dichotomous type of the key. When you try to identify the particular genera or particular species or particular taxa, then only you will come to know to identify the plant is not a simple or not a very easy task, because many times the terms or the words which are used in the literature in the form of the key are difficult to understand, and hence it is very much necessary to understand the morphology of the angiosperms with each and every word which is used in angiosperm taxonomy. These keys which are included in the different floras again falls into the two different categories, that is indented keys, and second one is bracketed or the parallel keys. In most of the floras you will find the indented key, but in certain cases there is bracketed key also. Unconventional method of the identification includes the polyclave identification method and even the cyber algorithm identification method. Till today we don't have much more awareness, much more availability of the softwares or the databases which can precisely identify the plants with the help of cyber algorithms. Though we can find out the certain solution at a particular level, to the particular level, but until we can't go through the each and every taxonomic character of that particular species with the available literature, till then we will not be able to confirm that species. And hence, the best method to identify any plant is nothing but the descriptive identification with the help of keys which are given in the flowers. The nomenclature include the common or the vernacular names, then international or the scientific names. Whenever we have to see these common names of any organism, we will find that there are the different names in the different area according to the language to the same organism. Means if you will see the name to the mango in the different languages, in the different localities, there will the different names. And hence, here the common names are many with respect to the number of languages which are spoken in the India. And hence, there is necessity to have the certain specific type of the name or international names, or which are considered as a scientific name, for the communication among the plant taxonomist or the peoples or the stakeholders who are working in the plant sciences in and around the globe. This include earlier the polynomial system and then trinomial system, and now the most accepted system, that is nothing but the binomial system of the nomenclature, which is given by Linnaeus, which contain the two names to the particular taxa, that is first one, that is the generic name, and second one as a specific name. Again, this includes the rules and regulation which are given by International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, that is ICBN. This includes the principles, rules, typification, then principles of priority, names of the genera, means the rules for the names of the genera, rules for the names of the species, then rules for the names of the cultivated plants, then about the author citation. Whenever we have to see the name of the plant, you will find that there is a citation of the author who discovered it. It is according to the principles of priority. Then rejection of names, and again the certain corrections in the names, that is comes under the orthography. In description of the plant include the habit of the organism, that is it is either herb, shrub, tree, climber, twiner, liana, etc. Then habitat of the organism, that is the dwelling place, as it is wild plant or cultivated plant or the crop plant or the ornamental plant, etc. Then type of the roots which are present, because if we see the different roots or the different plants and their roots, you will find a lot of difference and the modifications in it. Then type of the stem and its modification. Then type of the leaf, and there are the thousands of characters of the leaves which are used as a taxonomic characters. Then type of inflorescence among the angiosperms, and then flower, which include the bract, bracteoles, epicalyx, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, then floral formula and floral diagram. So this comes under the description or the morphology of the angiosperm, including the characteristics of the fruit, means the classification of the fruit or the development of the particular type of the fruit in a particular family or a particular group of the angiosperms. Then type of the seeds and the modifications among the inflorescence, flowers, stem, leaves, roots, and different floral parts, including the fruits and the seeds also. Then in addition to the classical taxonomy, there are some other branches of the taxonomy that are modern trends in the taxonomy. In this, the traditional versus modern taxonomy, we have to learn about how we can take the help of the recent advances in the different branches of the subject to solve the problems of the angiosperm taxonomy that comes under the modern taxonomy, which includes the cytotaxonomy, means we have to see the chromosome number, arrangement of the chromosomes, presence of the centromere, etc. Then palynology and the taxonomy, means to study the pollen grains, which is one of the interesting branch, because when we have to see the pollen grains of the different plant, we will find the very much different structures of this pollen grain that becomes one of the important characters during the classification of the taxa. Then embryology and a taxonomy, we have to see the embryo or the type of the ovules which are present, attachment of the ovules, type of the placentation, all these characteristics or the embryological characteristics. Then anatomy, internal structure of the organism, that may be characteristics of the root, that may the anatomy of the stem, anatomy of the flower, etc. Then floral anatomy, that the arrangement of the different arrangement of the vascular bundles of the different floral holes. Then position of the different floral holes, that we can study through the floral anatomy. Then ecotaxonomy, means we have to study the ecology in relation to that of the taxonomy. Then chemotaxonomy, means on the basis of the presence of particular chemical compounds to solve the problems of taxonomy that comes under the chemotaxonomy. Say for example, if you see the Asclepiadaceae family, then you will find that the plant develops or produces the latex, which is one of the characteristics, and this is one of the chemical compound. Then serotaxonomy, means the presence of a particular type of the proteins or the antibodies and the antigens with a particular type of stimulus, that comes under the serotaxonomy. Then biosystematics, then numerical taxonomy and phylogenetics. So this will comes under the modern trends in taxonomy. The origin and phylogeny includes geological time of the angiosperms, then cradle of angiosperms, probable ancestors of angiosperms, and fourth one is primitive angiosperms and evolutionary lines. In geological time of the angiosperm, we will be able to find out the age of the angiosperms with respect to the geological period. Then cradle of angiosperms include the polar hypothesis and Pacific basin hypothesis. The polar hypothesis was proposed by here in 1868, and this hypothesis holds the origin of angiosperms in high altitude and Arctic and Antarctic polar regions of the globe, while the Pacific hypothesis was proposed by Hallier in 1912 and is in opinion that the possible origin of angiosperm is Andes, Hawaiian Islands, New Caledonia and New Zealand, etc. In addition to this, there are many theories put forward by many authors. This includes isoetes or the monocotyledon theory. The isoetes monocotyledon theory given by Campbell in 1928 and advocated the isoetes is the ancestor of angiosperms. The second one, that is the cycadophytian theory, and this theory was given by Pant in 1957 and holds the fossil angiosperms Cycadopsida as ancestor of angiosperms, like Glossopteris, Ketonia, Pentoxylon, Cycadioidea, etc. These are also given in the syllabi of the UG and PG as the different theories. Then coniferals and amentiferi theory, which is given by Engler and Randall, and they considered as a amentiferous group of the families of angiosperms like Crassulaceae, Salicaceae, Fagaceae, etc., shows resemblances with the conifers of gymnosperms. Then the Nettle theory. In this, here the Wettstein in 1901 emphasized a close relationship of nettles and angiosperms. Then phyllospermy and the stachyospermy. In phyllospermy, the ranals and magnolials are considered to be developed from Cycadales, while in the stachyospermy, it is considered that the nettles are the possible ancestors of the amentiferi and some of the monocotyledons. According to Devrient theory, which is given by Corner in 1949 and is based on the first-hand knowledge of the tropical forest regarding phylogeny, phytogeography, ecology, and morphology of angiosperms, he considered Durio Juventius of Bombaceae from Burmese and Malayan forest as surviving model of primitive angiosperms, which is the characteristic feature of the Devrient theory. Then primitive angiosperms and evolutionary lines. There are the three different lines of the evolution among the angiosperms, in which the first line, second line include the dicotyledons, then dicotyledons, monocotyledons respectively, while third line include the evolution of monocotyledons. The most important part with respect to the syllabi of UG and PG botany in different Indian universities, there is an inclusion of families from the dicotyledons and the monocotyledons. In upcoming lectures, we will cover all these families which are included in the syllabi of UG and PG from dicot and the monocot. And we will consider the saline features of the families so that the student can come to know the characteristic feature of that particular family. This will also help the students and researchers to identify the plants of a particular family. Then general classification means the systematic position of the particular plants and the families according to the different classification proposed by the different authors. Then distribution, which include the distribution of the plants of that particular family in India and rest of the part of the world. Then number of genera and number of species of that family, so that we will be able to know about the total number of genera and species of that particular family, so that we will be able to know the size of that family in angiosperms also. Then taxonomic description, right from the root to the seed, including floral formula and floral diagram for that particular family. Then introduction to common plants of the family. This will help the researcher and even the teachers in plant sciences. Without taxonomic specialization, so that they will be aware about the many local plants of the different families. Then keys for the genera and the species, so that the plants can be easily identified with the help of these keys. And lastly, the economic importance will also be given in each family, so that the student can take benefit of these different lectures on angiosperm taxonomy for their studies for the university examinations. So thank you very much for your patiently listening of this lecture. In upcoming lectures of this angiosperm taxonomy series, you will be completely aware about your syllabus in UG and PG. So kindly like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel, and also press bell icon for the alerts of every lecture to be uploaded on this Life Science Titles. Thank you. Thank you very much.